Hello my friends, it's me, Rhymeager from Arduino PAX. I want to show you a demo about my new project. I switched to another display. The old one was the MEXXXQT with 320 to 240 pixels with 3 inches. And the new one has 7 inches and a resolution of 800 to 480 pixels. It has a SD card slot and it is driven by an Arduino Mega 2560. That's only a prototype version. I put its wooden parts on it for better standing. And now I show you the system. It's based on PRXOS, my own system that I used in early projects like the Arduino MIDI sequencer AM80A FireX3, but now with another concept. The main idea was to save a lot of RAM, and I reached this aim with outsourcing all the stuff on SD card. All controls, all the strings, all the colors, and even the letters of the on-screen keyboards are on the SD card. And there is only one value of it in the RAM at the same time. That saves a lot of memory where I can use for my program, but with a very, very nice interface to control it. The system uses layouts, and each layout can contain a lot of elements like labels or buttons or sliders. And the tricky dicky part of the system is I can generate various layouts with any change of the sketch. This is a complete system where I can make everything with it without knowing anything about C or C++. You can paint your layouts like paintbrush on a PC. At this time I'm in layout 1. I put some buttons on the top to switch between the layouts. In the second layout I put in some sliders. I think the third one is empty, and in the last one I put in two containers. A container can hold a lot of elements and has the ability to scroll down. For example, a group of radio buttons has a property for only one active button. But if you need a second group of radio buttons, you have to put the second group inside the container. You know this from other operating systems like Windows or Unix. Now we come to the different control elements. There are the standard elements from the old version of PRXOS. We have checkboxes or radio buttons and the so-called value fields. That are fields that can hold a value with a free selectable min and max range. The sliders are better looking value fields, and both of them have buttons for D and increase the value step by step. Of course you can use the keypad to put in your value. You don't must use the bar for this. And all the texts where you see all the stuff on the display are external on the SD card. Now I will show you how to control the system. If I press at the bottom of the screen for 7 seconds, it will open the admin bar. In this bar you can control everything, like the strings or the letters for the keypads. You can add or delete controls, you can manipulate the color table and do all the stuff without any changes of the sketch. My intention for the project was to control an old synthesizer with cryptic menus. For example, I have a Roland XP10 and it is a very good synth, but the configuration of it, it's everything but not a piece of cake. You have to switch down long and big menus to change the envelope or the attack or the decay. And with my system I can generate a layout where I can control the whole synth without entering any menus. And that is fucking awesome. But you can do everything, it's not only for synth. For example, you can control a servo with a slider or switch on a digital I/O with a button. That's no problem. And that's the idea of my system. I hope you enjoy this video and I will see you soon with the new stuff and new projects and new versions of the system. Have a nice day. Your geek, Rymega from Arduino PRX. Bye bye.